percentage of alcohol in the tank is this equation. So to solve this equation, we should use integrating factors, like what we learned last lesson. So here, after, by solving, it becomes like this, thus you will get this equation. So when Q equals 10 and K equals 0, you will find P. After that, you'll get the particular solution, which is this one. So when P equals 10, you'll get Q. You'll get 21.86 gallons of alcohol in the tank after 10.
So for problem number 2, you have to look for how much salt is in the tank when it overflows. So first, you have this equation. And then from this is the standard equation. From this, you have to look for the integrating factor, which is 200 plus p squared. And then the integrating factor, you have to multiply to q prime, which is this equation. And then to get the standard equation to look for the salt is this equation. And then as P is equal to 0 and Q is equal to 5, you can look for C, which is -4,600,720. Since you have C already, you can input C to the general equation, which is this again. And as Q is equal to, as P is equal to 300, you can obtain the how much salt is in the tank when it overflows, which is 279.790.
So what's the problem? This is the given. And then this is the standard equation. To input all the given, the standard equation. Then following the format of this one, you get the integrating factor. After getting the integrating factor, the formula for integrating factor, you compute for C by making time 0 and using the Q naught, which is 2 kilograms. After inputting it, you get C, and then from the input this time to get the remaining salt after 10 minutes.